Hello everyone, I welcome you all to Geeky Script. Today I am going to show you a very beautiful AI code editor called Cursor. So first I am going to show you how to install this Cursor AI code editor, and then I am going to show you how to use it for different programming languages like Python, HTML and all that. And after that I am also going to talk about how to use their AI functionality for improving your coding. So to watch the video till the end, I can guarantee if you watch the video till the end, you will be learning a lot of new things. And if you are still facing issues in middle, you can always ask me on comment sessions. And if these videos are really helping you, then please do mention that on comment sessions. That will really encourage me to make more of these kind of videos. So let's set a target of about 100 comments under this video. Alright, so let's dive in into our video. So now to install Cursor, you need to first simply go to favorite browser and to type over here, Cursor AI download. Hit enter. So that will show you this cursor.com. So just simply go to their official site. So this link I'm going to provide right in your channel description. Once when you're here, you will get that it is available for Windows. But if you're using some other operating system like macOS and all, then you can always, you know, download by just simply clicking on that. All downloads. For Windows, I'm just going to click on this download for Windows, and immediately it's going to start downloading our cursor. I have already downloaded it, so I'm going to cancel it. I'm going to minimize my browser. I'll go to my download directory, and here is our cursor. So the file size is just 110 MB. Just double click on the installer. It's going to show you this license agreement. You must read this and click on next. So this is where our cursor is going to be installed. Totally fine. Again, next. You need to select all these different options and click on next. So ready to be installed, click on install. So immediately it's going to start installing our cursor. Let's minimize our download directory and wait for a couple of minutes over here. And there you go. So you can see that it is rightly installed. So launch cursor is rightly checked also. Click on finish to launch our cursor. So welcome to cursor. So here it is telling to sign in. You can see it also telling AI features required to log in. So we are going to log in also. For the time being, just simply click on skip and continue. And it is telling whether you like to import all settings from Visual Studio Code. We don't want, we want to start it from scratch. So let's click on skip and continue. So now it will have three different themes. You can choose anything you want. I'm going to choose this cursor dark midnight and I'm going to click on continue. So agent is fine, or you can, you know, make it cursor tab as well. So let's make it cursor tab and click on continue. Here it is telling me they like to share some data to improve their product. So you can always share some data with them, or you can also go for privacy mode. I'm going to share data with them because that will only help to improve their product. Next is here in review settings, it is telling whether I'd like to install this terminal. So you can install it. Just install and give administrative privileges. So our shell command cursor is successfully installed now. So just click on continue, and there you go. So you can see that our cursor is rightly open, and this is the interface of our cursor. So let's open a project that I have recently created. So open folder, and I have just created a resume project on Python. So I'm going to select that and I'm going to click on select folder. So you'll be seeing that project is actually opened over here. So on that video I have talked about this UV Python package manager, or project manager you can say. So it's a really beautiful new enhancement that came on Python. So here is our code. So what this project basically does is basically it will going to give you a GUI interface, and there you can fill all the forms, and it's going to capture all that and going to generate a very beautiful resume file. So if I open and show you this file, so it's going to show like this. So you can see this entire thing I have, you know, created by this Python project. So if you just simply go to terminal and click on new terminal, and just simply type uv run main.py, hit enter. So that will open this GUI form. and you can fill all these details on this form, starting from profile summary to education, skill and all that. And you can also add a profile photo also. So just simply click on generate PDF resume and you'll get a resume generated over here. So if you go to your project folder, you can see this Rupa Pandit resume is created. So when you open that, you can see it going to look something like this. So you can customize it, you can give your own profile summary and all that. You can even modify this project to add a new field and everything you can do. So this entire project is open sourced and you can get it on our GitHub account. I have also prepared a detailed article on that also, and I have made a video also that you are going to get on this playlist. So you can, you know, basically use Cursor AI for creating any Python project. So that is what I just wanted to show you by just simply opening this Python project that I have recently created. Now let's say you want to understand a bit about some of the functions or the code that I've implemented on this project. So let's say you want to understand about this bit of code. So like this upload photo function. So what it is actually essentially doing. So for that you can just ask this Cursor AI itself. So you need to first log in. So let's log in first. Just click on this login icon. Just provide your email ID. You can always use this email sign in. So that's going to send you a code. Just use that code to log in into Cursor. So you can see now that we are logged in. Yes, login. So our authentication is rightly done, and there you go. So you can see that we are now logged in. So now let's say you want to understand this function, right? So just select that and just click on this add to chat. So that's going to automatically add this part of code to our chat window. And then you can just ask this AI to explain this code. Hit enter. So that's going to immediately start generating, explaining each and every single function. So that is because, you know, both our main.py and this part of code both are selected. So that's why it started explaining all the codes that we have written. So it's just not only explaining this particular upload photo function, it is, you know, explain each and every single function that we have written. So you can always read this, you can understand, and you can even generate code as well. Alright, now let's see how to generate code also. So you can let's create a project first. So you'll be able to know how to create a project also on Cursor AI. So just go to file and click on open folder, and let's create a new folder, and let's name this file as HTML cursor, let's say, and just select that folder. So you're going to open a new instance of Cursor by opening our HTML Cursor project. So you can see it is actually open. You can create a new file and give this file name, let's say, as index.html. And just simply type HTML. That's going to give you this boilerplate. So just double click on it, and you are having a boilerplate now. So now if you see, what's happening is when I'm not typing, I just selected this line number 9, right? And immediately you can see a sample code already came over here, and it's grayed out, right? So it's not inserted yet, but it is just giving you a suggestion, like whether you like to add one h1 tag with a hello world, you know, note written over here. So if you just simply hit tab on your keyboard, immediately you will see that is rightly populated, right? So you hit enter, again it given you a suggestion, like this is a paragraph, whether you like to add this. So again you tab, you can see that is rightly added, right? And it has again given one more suggestion where it is adding Google search feature. So again, if you hit tab, that is directly added. So if you hit enter, you get again one more suggestion, again tab, and you can see that it is populated. So it's just a demo. So when you'll be actually writing your code, you'll get all these different suggestions that are going to really help you to program or to build your product much faster. And if you are having any doubt while coding, you can always use this agent by just asking it, and it's going to solve it or generate a code for you. All right, now let's see how to run this project. So first, let's go to these extensions, and you can download any extensions. Like in Visual Studio Code, we had that extension, right? So similar to that, they also having. So you can type something like HTML. So on the marketplace, there are all these different extensions are available. So let's install a couple of popular extensions like this HTML CSS support. Let's install that. Let's also install this HTML preview. So let's install that. Now you have both these two extensions installed. So let's go back to our code and first go to file and save our file. And now what you can do is, if you just click on this icon, so that's going to open this preview HTML. So you can see whatever you have written here is already rendered into cursor editor itself. And the same thing when you just right click on this file and just click on the show in browser, that same project going to render on our browser. You can choose the browser that you'd like to open. I'll choose Chrome. So here also you can see whatever you have written on your code, so that thing is getting rendered over here. And the benefit of using this preview HTML preview is whatever you are writing, so like you hit enter and it again give you this suggestion. So just you hit tab and you can see that it is rendering it on this live preview window automatically. So you hit tab and that it got rendered. Or you just manually type something within h3 tag, let's say, and you can see that is also getting rendered. So all these different extensions from marketplace you can also use on cursor AI code editor, and parallelly you can also use their AI code agent for creating your project much faster. All right, so yeah, so that's basically all about this video. Don't forget to watch our other Python tutorials that I'm making on this channel. So all these video links along with our GitHub, our article, everything I'm going to post right in our channel description. So don't forget to watch them. And lastly, special thanks to the supporters of our channel. We are truly grateful to you guys. Supports like this really motivate us to create and improving these videos. Again, thanks a lot for being an essential part of our journey. And also, if my videos are really helping you, don't forget to like, share and subscribe. That's going to really motivate me to make more and more this kind of videos. So that's basically all about this video, friends. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.